Framations, I am here with our second place winner from the Serenity exhibition, which runs through November 9th, 2021. Come in and see it if you're in town. But Thomas Herbst, he has this beautiful photography of the Maroon bells. Thomas, can you tell us a little bit about your work here?
Sure. Well, as you know, the theme is serenity, and just looking, reflecting on my own pieces I submit, apparently I find water very serene because three of the four pieces have water in them. Obviously, Maroon Bells has this amazing reflection in the Maroon Lake, and then Finger Lakes here is actually one that I took as well with a nice reflection of the autumn colors. But yeah, so this is a scene I took a couple years ago in Colorado.
Now, you told me you're a geologist.
I am a geologist.
So you get to travel around and explore all these sites and have the opportunity to take all these magnificent photographs. What are you shooting with?
I just shoot with a DSLR and a Nikon camera. Actually, an entry-level camera still. I still keep my original camera that I got back when my dad took me to a camera store about 10 years ago. And I still have the same kit.
Oh, my. Now I'm feeling old. Like, I work in the photo industry back in the 80s and 90s before digital came out. So your first camera was a digital camera.
It was a little Nikon. My first camera was a little Nikon point and shoot.
Was it a Nikon Coolpix?
It was a Coolpix. It was a Coolpix. Yes, and now
awesome.
And this photo was taken still with the Nikon D3200 that I picked up at Creef Corps Camera many years ago when they were still over in... I think that was the one was in Baldwin.
Yeah, Nikon makes some of the best lenses in the world. I mean, they're mm-hmm. right up there, so they're pretty amazing, and they give you some free shots. Now, are you printing your own work too, or do you send that out?
I do a third-party printing.
Third-party printing.
Yes. I'm actually, one of my biggest goals of this year was to print more.
Sure.
This is actually my first set of exhibition prints.
Okay.
So I haven't done much printing, and... but I'm glad how these turned out because I wasn't sure, you know, with an entry-level camera and things.
Right.
But it just shows you that it's just a tool, and it's just more important to get out there.
Well, I mean, so long as your printer is the printer that you're using is calibrated correctly, you should get good true mm-hmm. color with digital work.
Right.
So, do you do any editing on your?
Yes, I do post processing typically in Photoshop. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, generate a raw file, which are inherently undersaturated,
mm-hmm.
but the raw file gathers a lot more data in it than, say, a JPEG, so I can pull up the shadows, bring down the highlights, and has a lot more dynamic range in it. Not, say, as much as our eyes, which is why occasionally you might have to expose for a very bright sky or something.
Sure.
This, for example, was in one shot.
That's wonderful.
So because it was dawn and pre-sunrise, I could still have just enough light on the mountains and be able to have enough data in the shadows.
Morning or mm-hmm. evening?
Morning.
Morning.
Yep.
How long did you get to stay? The Maroon Bells, are we all jealous?
This was taken at about, I want to say, 5:30 a.m.
Wow.
And I was actually on my way back from the field. I was doing 3 weeks of field work in Northern California. And I was driving back, and it was about mid-September. I was hoping to catch the fall colors, and you just see a little hints of yellow in there,
yep.
But I was told about 2 weeks a little early. But when I arrived at the parking lot, it was almost entirely full, and I'm glad that I mixed up the time zones, because I was 2 hours ahead of sunrise, and it's already full, and it turned out it was all hikers. I was the first photographer on site, so I had this whole place all to myself.
Did anybody end up joining you photography-wise?
Yes.
How many people ended up showing up with
there was probably about 20 tripods lined in the area by the time
it
was
done. It is an often shot place, but you did a fantastic job.
It is an icon, absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And now tell us a little bit about this piece. This is called Finger Lakes. Mm-hmm. Finger Lakes Park.
This is Finger Lakes State Park, yes.
Okay.
The Finger Lakes are... I'm gonna nerd out a little bit of my geology here, but these are actually former coal mines that they would mine out, and they had coal pits that are from 300 million year old bedrock that had coal deposits in it.
Wow.
And so then they get filled up with water, and now we have this amazing, park that people can go
visit. Where is Finger Lakes?
It's just north of Columbia, Missouri.
Just north of Columbia.
So I'm a doctoral candidate studying volcanology actually at Mizzou. So this is just 10 minutes north of me.
Do you know when Yellowstone's going?
I get this question all the time. The best way I can describe it is someone once told me Yellowstone is like a baked potato, so it all just depends on how you heat it or cool it. And in my opinion right now, I think it's there's no danger.
No danger?
In the immediate vicinity, yes, I think.
It's so just, do you think I'm going to live to be an old lady, or is it going to go before I got my walker?
If it does, you'll go out with a bang. I mean, I think it's just going to sit under there like a baked potato eventually turn into a granite, but
I've heard that it's actually slowing down and not going to actually go into another cataclysmic event.
It is just, think of it like a big pot of magma sitting under the cooling slowly. So like Elephant Rocks, most people in Missouri are familiar with the Elephant Rocks. It will turn into effectively that, a large granite dome that may eventually, once erosion catches up with that big granite area down there, it might expose itself and be something similar to Elephant Rocks. But like the eruptions that we're seeing and that we saw in Hawaii and things, that happens because we have intrusions of hotter, newer magma, and that can regenerate a system and cause an eruption. So that's why scientists say
you never know.
Right now, in my opinion, I think we're okay, at least for a few decades.
Well, it's cool. I don't think I've ever met somebody whose specialty was volcanology. I mean, that's interesting, and he's an artist on top of it. That's a great combination.
It does afford me the opportunities, like you said, to get out. And it's amazing to me how rarely stated it is that some of our most amazing landscapes are just as equally synonymous with amazing geology.
Yes.
Like all the rocks of the Southwest that are photographed so often, those would not be there without those geologic processes.
Exactly. I remember a few things from school. There's sedimentary layers,
right? Yes.
And there's, volcanic rock is made from magma because it cools. I did pay a little bit of attention in science.
There you go.
Actually, I'm a science geek. I love science. But all the more reason, get your kids involved in art because it expands their minds. It gets them more into the sciences and the math. It helps them process and think outside the box. So we love that. Now, you've got a couple more pieces in the show, right?
I do, yes.
You want to go talk about those real quick?
Yeah, absolutely. All right. Over in gallery too. Yeah.
We're going to pause this. We'll be right back. So, Leaf House, tell us a little bit about this piece.
So obviously with the pandemic, we all couldn't get out of the house very often. So when the fall time came last year, we took advantage of some nice weather we had here in southern Missouri. So my partner and I spent a couple of weeks camping in southern Missouri. So three to four pieces I've submitted here we're taking in the fall in southern Missouri. And this one is down around Shannon County.
Did you get to ride the horses?
I did not get to ride the horses. One lone white horse actually came up to me and I fed him an apple. He was the most sociable one, but these few just stayed at a distance.
Yeah.
And it was almost like they were using this tree for shelter. It was amazing. There was this amazing atmosphere in the air, and this tree was just holding on to its fall colors as long as it could, because this was early November.
Yeah.
And you can see all the other trees are starting to fall off, lose their leaves, and this one was still holding strong, and then these horses, found it. Found a little shelter there.
Wonderful shots. And a lot of things with photography, it's just set timing, being at the right place at the right time.
It was completely random, yes. Yeah. I mean, we were on our way to another location, actually, and it's so funny how often that happens.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the best picture you'll never take will be 1/64th of a second late.
Right? I love that saying. This, too, is in Shannon County, just outside of... some landscape photographers are a little cagey about their locations, but everyone in southern Missouri should know where this is. It's just outside of Winona, Missouri, in Shannon County.
That's beautiful.
My dad actually grew up in Winona, so he would tell me stories about, as kids, they would slide down this waterfall, which baffled me, because every time I've been there, it's like, there's quite a bit of water that goes over those falls, but it's a little, not that much water, a little too jagged for me.
Oh, my.
This too, though, is all about timing. I see we stopped by here again, 10 minutes left in daylight, and I wasn't sure if the light was going to kick off, and this beautiful sunset just happened to catch the last little bit of the high clouds 2 minutes at most is all that light lasted. So I love this piece though for the colors of the rocks. Yeah. We spoke about the geology earlier. This too is a volcanic rock.
Okay.
So not like a granite that stays underground and takes time to cool. This one was actually erupted at some point by an ancient volcano, because our mountains, even though we have, they're probably hills now by some people's standards, they at one point were quite large mountains, and we did have volcanoes here in Missouri some 1.2 billion years ago.
So we have volcanoes in Missouri?
That's right, yeah.
Now that's something I wasn't really... What's the next eruption in Missouri?
Oh, we don't anticipate any eruptions.
No.
No, they are long gone and
okay,
and
well, how about dormant. The New Madrid Fault?
No comment?
No comment,
I guess.
I did buy earthquake insurance for my house. If you don't have it and you live in Missouri, you better get earthquake insurance.
You know, I mean, we do have the New Madrid Seismic Zone. And
yes.
There, what's fortunate about that, though, is that... It is a heavily studied area.
Mm-hmm.
Its fault zone, though, is quite deep, which makes it difficult to image from seismology. But the biggest hazard, I should say, is not necessarily from actual shaking, but from what we call liquefaction.
Mm-hmm.
So the high water table and a lot of clay holding down a large deposits of sand and things will actually liquefy under intensive shaking. And so that, of course, can cause structural damage. And we see that evidence from the earthquakes back in 1812. But back in,
that's
say,
the one that made the Mississippi River run backwards,
right?
And didn't it jump the, change course?
I'm sure it did. I'm sure the meanders and the pathways of the river probably did change, but back then the Boot Heel was not nearly as populated as it
yes.
is now, nor was St. Louis.
Right.
So different story these days, but...
Like I said, get earthquake insurance if you live in the Missouri area. It's not a bad idea.
But what's nice, though, is, and I've worked with some of the best people at the state, too, like, it's a heavily studied area. It's mm-hmm. it's heavily monitored, too, so... Hopefully, if something does happen, we'll have some nice data. And no one can really predict these things. That's kind of the caveat.
Yeah, but if you had to just take your best guess.
I'm not going to go there.
No, we can't get, okay.
No.
See, 50 to 100 years.
No, I think even Einstein said, or someone said, someone probably pointed out, say, no, so-and-so said this. But we learned geology the day after the earthquake.
The day after the earthquake. That is a great quote. See, I had a good one. You got a good one. Way to go. All right, well, on that happy note, oh, wait, I got one more thing. Where can we see more of your work?
Unfortunately, I don't have a website. I'm now, I'm still just very new.
You're
to
just going
to
have to come in and see it. That's
yes,
all
that's there
here.
You go. I do have an Instagram at thomas.herbst.photographer.
Okay, do you want me to link to that?
Absolutely.
Okay,
you're
I'll
sure.
do that.
More than welcome to.
All right, well, on that happy note, it's been a lot of fun chatting with you.
Yes, it's been a pleasure.
Next time you want to do a show here, let's do it again.
Absolutely.
All right. If you want, you can also put in the comments, what was your favorite piece of Thomas's? Did you have a favorite? Why? We'd love to hear those comments. And as always, enjoy art. Get out there. Do some photography. Do some art. Make some art. Enjoy it. Go look at it. Appreciate it. And we'll chat later. Have a great day.